Kayvon Fowler, Body Flow, Sheffield. Don't know anything about him at all, really, apart from going to fight him. And his name's Simon Harvey, or Harley. I'm going to punch him, he's going to punch me. See what happens. Just looking forward to it, really. Looking forward to fighting.
Right.
Should be fun.
Bring vibes on a club night, keep the crowd hyped up, run a party red. She wanna say words in my earlobe, reminds me there's an hour of the party left. See the fireworks, celebration, team winning the great goose, amazing. Send them Jaeger bombs, I got a craving. So many women, I don't wanna stop raving. They should know I got tunes for the gal them. Once the ladies are there, see the man them reach. They wanna leave there with a number, check the painting, she's gonna hang with me. I'm skanking, all round the party, I'm skanking.
His opponent tonight, ladies and gentlemen, fighting out of the red corner, Simon Harley!
My name's Simon Harley, and I'm fighting out of Urban Kings. Kayvon Fowler, not fought for 2 years. He's got a wrestling background, and he's got heavy hands. Been training quite hard. I've had a week intense training up in Nottingham at the Spirit Dojo, training with Paul Semtex Daly, who's obviously one of the best pound for pound punchers in the UK. Wrestling defences are next to none because everyone wants to take him down. Training really hard.
Any predictions for the fight?
No, apart from it's going to be a good fight.
It's the life I chose. Gunshots in the dark, one eye closed. And we got it cooking like a one-eye stove. You can kiss me kissing my girl with both eyes closed. Yeah, perfecting my passion, thanks for asking. Couldn't slow down, so we had to crash it. You use plastic, we bout cash. I see some people ahead that we gon' pass, yeah.
I never fear death or dying.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, this is bout number 6, a professional contest at the welterweight division. Introducing in the blue corner, he has a record of 2 wins and 2 defeats as a professional. He stands at 5'7". He has a shoot fighter background and fights at a Sheffield Shoot Fighters gym. He is Kayvon War Dog Fowler. And his opponent in the red corner. He has a record of 1 win and no defeats as a professional. He stands at 5'9". He's a striker who fights out of the Urban Kings gym. Introducing Simon Soulja Boy Harley.
War Dog versus the Soulja Boy. So we've got War Dog from Sheffield Shoot Fighters versus Urban Kings, the Soulja Boy.
Yep, this is our first professional bout of the night. Smaller gloves, longer rounds, and more exciting.
Both fighters evenly matched.
Tested each other's out, just feeling the water. I think they both put themselves down as strikers, so I think they'll be happy to stand for quite a while and see who gets the better of this before it goes to the ground, Alex. Nice overhand right by Kayvon. Found success with it. He's throwing punches and bunches.
He's throwing, but he's swinging. So,
And a nice takedown. Straight into side mount from Kayvon.
He's very powerful, very compact. 77 kilos, 5'7". He's got some muscle on him.
And he's going for that key lock, which we saw in the last fight. He's let go of it now. And he's just securing the side mount position. Taking his time, doing very well. His corner shouting, be patient, that's what he's doing.
Yeah. I mean, War Dog, he's a bigger, heavier, he's a heavier guy. He's a more muscled guy, that's the wrong word. He's a more muscled guy.
Yeah,
he's more compact. So
he's
it would favour him to hold him down, ground and pound him.
Yeah, Simon being a longer fighter, being underneath and sideman is going to be one of your hardest positions to escape.
But then, you know, when we were standing up, War Dog was really throwing the leather.
And he's throwing it again there from side mount. Simon's managed to get back to half guard. It's a lot better than being in side mount, so he can work from here.
Yes.
Pushing off the fence. He's got a little cut over his nose just at the moment, so once Kayvon sees that, he might want to capitalize on that and you see the blood and he'll start throwing more leather.
Have elbows.
Ah, yes, elbows on the ground on this show.
One good elbow could really make a vicious difference.
Man, one good elbow can cut you really bad and that could be the end of the fight.
Ooh,
but he's happy to throw the leather.
Shots.
He's throwing big punches. He's kept a good base. He's going for the choke. He's not got his hooks in. But
a position submission. You haven't got the position, you're not going to get it.
Yeah, like you said earlier, he's gone for the submission first without having a position. So let's see if he can get it. Now he's got the position.
I don't know. He's got his hooks.
And there you go. Simon does a good job of escaping.
I'm impressed. He could get. This is a good position for War Dog. Oh, powerful.
Nice knee on the way up. And
right,
back to standing.
Cardio's like now. The Simon, the soldier boy, he trains with Paul Daly, so.
Yeah.
Not good.
You know, Paul Daly's quality, he's the best stand up fighter going in the UK.
He's got
a
lot of muscle there, Wardog, hasn't he?
And he's tried a flying knee, it was a nice attempt. I think he just missed. Kayvon looks a bit gassed to me, his hands down by his side, that's very dangerous. You can't let your guard down for a second in a fight like this.
Yeah, he's come out very powerful.
Do you think he's blown a lot of gas by doing that early on?
Look, he's tough. He's still calm, still cool. He's not panicking, he's still in that. He's just like, all right, okay.
Big overhand right for Simon. I think he needs to throw more combinations and he'll probably catch him with something.
I don't know, my fantasy mind saying that War Dog's had a few street fights, because the way he's fighting, although he's only had four fights and he's been training 9 years, he's had a lot of experience. He's confident.
Yeah,
but
he's
the
very
thing
confident.
Is, you come in against a young kid who's hungry, confidence counts for something, but if the kid trains more than you...
Yeah, you could pay heavily for that confidence. I mean, big leg kick. You can see the Kayvon's power there. Simon throws his own back, doesn't quite land. Switch kick to the left.
So Soldier Boy's keeping it long range. Trying to avoid those heavy, heavy hands from War Dog.
He's doing a good job of keeping it long range, but I'd like to see a few more combinations to get it really going. It's all one shots.
Well, if,
big overhand, big leg kicks.
Soldier Boy's clever. If you kick him in the leg at that long range, kick the fenders, his hands come down, then switch it to the head.
Yeah, he just caught him with a nice uppercut there, Alex.
And he's not called Soldier Boy for nothing. He is a Soldier Boy, so he's going to have some good cardio, good endurance.
I think Kayvon's best bet is to get this back to the ground. I think that's where he was winning this fight. The stand up, I think Simon's just a bit too long for him, a bit too rangy. And he knows how to use it well. But Kayvon comes back with a nice leg kick. A show of respect there.
Oh, cool. That's fine. He's going to go over on his ankle.
Kayvon got his guard up just in time there with that big head kick. And 10 seconds left. I think they'll be glad to see the end of this round to catch a few breaths. Who would you give this round to, Alex? It's a hard one.
Even.
Nine grand in, and then 9-5 is the first one. How's it take that gun? Shoot your legs now, I mean like disco legs.
Round two underway.
Here we go.
A very action-packed first round. Both guys got a minute to catch their breaths. Let's see what they got in this round.
You were saying there, Matt, that our Soldier Boy, he's only had one fight and he won that in 56 seconds. But you know, that would give him some confidence, but then at the same time, you could be super fit in these fights. Yeah, you know, super fit as an athlete, but the nerves can take it so much out of you.
Yeah, you're right. We've both been there, Alex, and we know sometimes the nerves can just do something to your fitness sometimes. This is new territory for Soldier Boy. This is like,
especially
he's in the second round.
Street fight and you're used to having a few fights on the street. Yeah, I knock them all out and all of a sudden, hold on a second, this guy's going down.
Yeah, do you know what I mean? Whoa, big lever thrown there from Kayvon. Doesn't quite land. Goes for the Superman punch and right leg kick. Nice. Soldier Boy keeping his basic with his ones and twos.
That's good. Basic 1-2 works. Wins fights.
Definitely. We've seen it time and time again.
Range. He's got the agility and lighter feet.
Yeah, as you can see, those legs can go anywhere. He's throwing leg kicks, body shots and head kicks in this, so you never know where those legs are going.
A little bit of a welt there on Soldier Boy's left thigh. So it's reddening up.
Oh, and he capitalizes. Nice jabs going in from Soldier Boy there, keeping the range long, using his height to his advantage.
Well, he's a soldier, he's using tactics, which is good. We should train as an army soldier to use tactics. So he's going to listen to direction very well.
Oh, nice overhand right there. I don't know why Cable's not following up when he catches a big like that.
Wardog's got some power in that fight, in that fight kick. He's throwing that in.
Definitely, that's going to slow Soldier Boy down a lot.
Yeah, and another one goes in. But then there's also a danger there, which I learned against Dave Monet, ex-UFC middleweight champion of the world. He put a knee pad on his knee, so I kept kicking his knee. Every time I kicked his knee, he took me down.
Yeah, you got to be careful with those kicks. I've had fights myself where you throw a leg kick, it's very easy to get taken down from there.
Yeah.
But it doesn't seem like Soldier Boy wants this on the floor, really, to be honest. So I think that's why he's getting confident and he's happy to throw those leg kicks time and time again. Another one goes in.
We got that one in quick then.
And you can see it from here, Alex, can't you? Look at his leg.
The build up. I mean, I'm a kickboxer, that's my background. I love kickboxers. So I love to see the kickboxer. And he's covering up nice and tight now, Wardog. I like that. He's not being arrogant. I like that. Oh, tiny one, but nothing. He's powerful enough to shake it off.
Yeah, he's,
I'm enjoying this.
His guard's much better in this round, isn't it?
Oh, that.
Gumshield flies out. Just have a quick break.
I like his attitude. He's serious. Both of them.
And action goes again. Look
Come
at that
on,
leg.
Soldier Boy. Get in there.
I think he's going to keep going for that leg kick, Alex. He's going to work on that.
I think he is. You can see it's wobbling a little bit. So I learned to block it. You know he's coming. I actually saw him look down it. So Wardog, look at that fire. I'm going to eat that fire.
There's a big bulldog on that fire, isn't there? There's a big bullseye on that fire, and he's going to go for it. But yeah, not much checking going on from either guy with these kids.
No.
I don't think I've seen one check yet. They just sort of seem to take them. The adrenaline can take you so far, but you start feeling those after a while.
Oh, he got it again. He knows what to do. He's got a blueprint. And he's not checking.